Hey guys, in this video is how we do the testing and commissioning the Jinowa VRF system air conditioner. Okay, let's go together. The first thing that I'm going to show you is the inside the outdoor unit. There are 5 boards in the outdoor unit. The big one is the main board, which is get the power supply through the main board, and it will separate to another board by its generator. And then is, as you can see, the 2 small boards above is the board of the compressor, and there are 2 boards below the main board. You can see inside, those 2 boards are for the fan. And here is the connection of the power supply, A, B, C, N. A, B, C is the fast and N is the note. And here is the last is PQE, is the indoor unit communication. And H1, H2E is the outdoor unit communication. And here is the all the connection. K1, K2E is the outdoor unit central line monitoring. OAE is the network accounting. XYE is the indoor unit central line control. And PQE, indoor unit communication. And H1, H2E is the outdoor unit communication. And here is the main board power supply from the power supply A, B, C, E, and N. And supply to the compressor board. Is another compressor board. And here is the inside look of the compressor. The compressor, it uses inverter compressor. Supply, this is the power supply from the board I showed you last time. It uses the Hitachi compressor. The power supply is they say from 130 volt to 400 volts. It's a adjustable speed. And this Jinowa VRF, it has 2 compressors combined in 1 outdoor unit. And for some small capacity, it has only 1 compressor. It's depending on the catalog. And also, it has built-in with the 2 fans. On the top view, you can see there are 2 systems separately from each other supplied to the building. This before we can start the machine, this we have to test the continuity from the breaker to the outdoor unit to make sure that the power supply is not wrong from far 1, far 2, and 3. After continuity test, we have to test the power supply on the outdoor unit to make sure that the power supply is we have enough power supply in 380 volt. Far to far, A B A C and B C, all is 380 volts. And then we have to check from A and N, B and N, C and N to make sure there is 220 watt supply to fast and node. After the power supply checked already, now this time we have to check the phase. With this tool, it's called a phase checker. There are three cables, red, white, and blue. And the red is for the phase 1, white for the phase 2, and the blue one is for the phase 3. And then we have to press on the button of the tool, and you can see the rotation is going following the arrow. That means that it is the correct fire checker. After power supply confirmed, now this time we have to check all the wire is it open or not. And here is the compressor of the Jinowa. It uses a Hitachi compressor. After everything checked already, now it's time to address setting for the outdoor unit and indoor unit for the auto address. And for the master one, it display number 1. Slave 1 is display number 2. Slave 2 it gives number 3. And after the address auto address thing is already, now its machine is running. And this time our installer prepare to add the refrigerant into the system. This VRF system is requirement to have the R410A charged into the system and to calculate how many kilogram to add to the system. I will show you in the next few video. Okay, let's go on. Now our installer prepare to add the gas, the refrigerant into the system. By connect to the low pressure pipe, suction pipe, to the bottle of the refrigerant. Now it's done, and connect to the pressure gauge between the refrigerant and the system. Now they open the pressure gauge valve to add the refrigerant into the system. For this method, we have to put the refrigerant upside down to get the liquid refrigerant into the system. And you can see that this is the refrigerant is running into the system by the suction pipe from the compressor. And here all the spare refrigerant air 410A preparing to add into the system. You can see on the box. After finish one bottle, our installer have to turn off the valve first and prepare to add another tank of the refrigerant. And one tank of refrigerant it equal to 11 kilogram of the refrigerant inside the tank, and one system requirement at least from 20 to 40 kilogram. It's depending on the how long of the pipe and how many indoor unit. It have the calculation in the catalog. I will show you in the next few video. Now let's go on with the installation and the testing first. Now our service is preparing to upside down the refrigerant again. As I said, it the first we have to put it, add it in liquid. After add the refrigerant into the system, all the system is work well already. Now it's time for the testing for the ampere of the system. Now this the running ampere is around 20 to 27 ampere. And we have to test the pressure, is it enough pressure or not? It's for the final testing. This time we not connect into the refrigerant tank, we just only connect into the low pressure to get the working pressure of the system. To make sure that the working pressure and the ampere is correct. Okay, thank you guys for your time watching this short explanation video about the VRF Jinowa testing and commissioning system. Thank you for your time watching my video, and I hope you enjoy the video, and please don't forget to subscribe for more video. Thank you and bye bye. See you again in the next video.